Just practically unbelievable.
Well, take it easy, honey.
What would my father be doing picking up a suitcase with a bomb in it?
I can't help but wonder if Michael Grant's involved in this, too.
What makes you think so?
Well, he went to so much trouble to set you up with that hit and run. Maybe set Roger up, too.
He doesn't have anything against my dad, especially now that he's helping Herb Callison get elected for mayor. Megan.
Hi.
Hi.
Has Dad regained consciousness yet?
No, he hasn't. Not yet, but there is some good news. The head injury isn't as serious as they thought. Apparently, he's just suffering from a concussion.
Well, what about all the blood he lost?
Well, he cut an artery in his arm, but they've got that under control.
I'm telling you, after that explosion, when I saw him, I didn't think he was alive.
Well, he's tough, Megan. He's gonna be okay.
I would feel a lot better if he would just come to and say hi to us.
Yeah, if he's speaking to us. After the way we treated him, I'm not so sure.
Yeah, well, Vicky came over to the house today, and she said that I should be a little easier on Dad, that we shouldn't try and fight her battles for her.
Megan, what do you know about that suitcase with a bomb in it?
Nothing, really, except that obviously it was planted.
Yeah, but why did you know to go to that warehouse?
Oh, I didn't. Jake did. Lucky thing, too. It saved Dad's life.
What the hell are you doing here?
What's wrong, Gran? Huh? Didn't they tell you they screwed up? Or did you think they really killed me? Did you think I was dead?
Hey, don't do anything stupid, huh?
Like what? Waste you? After you tried to kill me, Megan, and Roger Gordon? Why not? I don't think it'd be so stupid. I think that'd be a very smart idea on my part.
Okay, who wanted the pretzels?
Right here, Andy.
Oh, gosh. There you go. Sorry, Cole. I'm losing it.
Hey, you're just busy. In fact, this place is rocking.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it? Tuesdays and Wednesdays used to be so dead in here, but, of course, you all know that because you're regulars.
Yeah, the two-for-one deal is really bringing them in now.
Hi, what can I get you?
How you doing, Andy?
Have you, been in here before?
Yeah, sure have.
What's your name? Did you hear me?
Yeah.
Hey, Andy, what happened to my beer?
Oh, would you keep your shirt on, Harv? I'm getting it for you. Here you go. Anything else, maybe?
Sorry, didn't mean to give you a hard time.
Oh, really? Oh, I'm sorry. Can I get you something to drink?
Yeah, mineral water would be great. Thanks.
Okay.
So how's my pal Al doing?
Oh, he's great. The babysitter took him to the park, and now he's upstairs taking a nap. He'll be here in a minute.
There you go. You really know how to handle a bar. I'm impressed.
Yeah, well, I don't know. I guess I just had to learn it.
Yeah. I mean, certainly not a talent you're born with.
No, but I am born with the talent of remembering people's faces, and I don't think I remember yours. When was the last time you were in here?
Andy!
Hi, I know you're up! Oh, how's your napping?
Welcome home. How was your trip?
Hey, where'd you go?
Oh, come on. You remember Carl and Harv?
You'll be okay in a little while.
Yeah, sure will. Just takes him a little time to get going after his nap, huh? No, he does look sleepy, doesn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, how about some milk and cookies? How would you like that? And guess what? I've got something very special. Your favorite in the VCR.
Hey, Harv. What's your favorite movie?
Look, do you mind backing up a little bit, okay?
Yeah, sure.
Look, just not too short of strangers, all right?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
How about that milk and cookies, huh? How about that? Let's go. Great.
Let's back up just a little bit. What was Roger doing at the warehouse?
Well, according to Dorian, he was quote-unquote on a wild goose chase. She says that's all she knows.
Dorian. Now, how does she figure into this?
Well, after Vicky left, I thought that what she had said made some sense, so I decided I would call Dad and make an appointment with him to talk to him. I knew that he was at the Waterside Inn, and when I called him to the phone, Dorian got on instead and said that he'd gone to Pier 32.
Do you think she knew what was going on?
She claims not to know anything about the bomb, but I don't know. My instincts tell me that she knew what was going on, that she was covering for either herself or for someone else.
Well, it's just a lucky thing that you went looking for your dad, because you probably saved his life.
Well, I think we have Jake to thank for that. He was there when I was on the phone with Dorian. He heard me mention Pier 32, and when I got off, he grabbed me, and we hightailed it to the pier.
Jake knew that Dad was in danger?
It's kind of a long story. He was beaten up by a couple of guys the other night, and they had mentioned something about bringing him to Pier 32 to kill him. So, when I mentioned the pier number, he thought that something was probably up.
Who's trying to kill Jake?
Don't ask. I mean, he's supposed to be some sort of private investigator, that's what he says, but for all I know, that could be a lie, too.
Well, let's get back to Roger. You and Jake, you drove to the pier, right?
Yes, and when we were about to enter the warehouse, we saw Dad. He was about to open up the suitcase, and we yelled for him not to do it.
Dad! Don't open that!
I guess we were too late, and the bomb exploded. Afterwards, we saw him. He was lying unconscious, covered in blood. I'm telling you, it's a miracle that he wasn't killed.
It's a miracle you weren't all killed.
We won't know that he's all right until he regains consciousness.
Well, the doctors say in all probability he will.
I hope so. I would like to have a chance to tell him I'm so sorry for the way we've been treating him lately.
Yeah, he really needs to hear how much we love him. I can't believe how angry we got at him. Although he did deserve a little of it.
You two just don't know what it's like to have a father who will surprise you and will disappoint you.
Yeah, I guess you're pretty used to it with Asa, huh?
Yeah. Where's Jake? I'd like to ask him a few questions.
That's a good question. I have no idea where he is. And even if he were here, I don't think you'd get a straight answer out of him.
I don't know what you're talking about.
No, you don't? They say confession's good for the soul, especially when you're going to meet your maker. You got any sins to get off your chest, Gran?
You wouldn't be able to pull off killing me.
Maybe I don't care. Maybe I'd get enough pleasure out of killing you. It would last me the rest of my life if I spent it in jail.
You know something, Jake?
What?
I was one of the sent those guys after. You know that, don't you? Just like I promised.
You are a man who sticks to his word, aren't you?
Huh? Why don't you take your hands off him and discuss this in a civilized manner?
What do you know about civilized?
Gave you $30,000.
Yeah, so you could hunt me down and kill me and get it back.
It's a lot more, Jake. A lot more where that came from. I'll give it to you. I'll give it to you if you just leave town, forget the past.
One, I'm not leaving Landview. Two, you're gonna tell me why you slept with Roger Gordon.
I don't know anything about it.
Well, no?
Yeah, just what I read in the news. I didn't set him up.
I know all about your operation. You're gonna tell me why you're gonna go down for killing him.
He's dead?
That's right. You got a little too careless, a little too arrogant. You think you can get away with anything, but you're wrong. You know what, Michael? It's all gonna fall apart in you. Guess what? I'm gonna be right there. I'm gonna testify against you.
Aren't you forgetting about your little Florida episode?
Who cares about that? Once I turn state's evidence against you and pin two murders on you, the cops aren't gonna care about that. The charges are gonna go bye-bye, just like you.
Now, Jake, there's only one intelligent course for you here. That's to take $250,000 and just be on your way.
Why? So you can track me down and shoot me later? I don't think so. I'm gonna be fine. It's you gotta worry about. You're looking at a long term in the slam, buddy. So why did you do it? Why did you have Megan Gordon's father killed, huh? Why did you set him up?
Fell for the actress, didn't you? Changed by the love of a good woman.
She is a good woman! It was you. It was you looking for dirt that wasn't there. The only dirt that exists is in your filthy mind.
Yeah?
You better get your affairs together, big shot. Because you're not coming back to this big house for a very long time.
I thought I told you to stay out here when I'm conducting business.
I'm sorry, what are you doing with the gun?
What?
I saw a gun and you had it aimed at whoever that is that was there.
Brenda? Brenda? It's my pocket calculator. Dropped it on the floor.
I'm sorry. I don't know what's the matter with me.
Well, now you're fine. You know that? You're fine, huh? I'm sorry, I Sorry, I snapped at you.
It's okay. Hey, you know, I came in because I have something really important to tell you.
Yeah?
And now I can't remember what it is.
Is that okay?
Yeah, look, I'm sorry for coming down here so hard. I mean, you're just trying to be friendly.
Don't worry about it. Most kids his age are skittish about strangers. I should have known better.
Well, it's just that his father, my brother, died a few months ago, and well, I thought he was getting over it, but he's, you know, he's still not sleeping through the nights, and he's become very shy, and strangers seem to scare him a lot. But he's a really great kid. I love him a lot.
Yeah, it shows. Well, it looks like you're handling your brother's death pretty well.
Well, it's funny. I always get the feeling like he's gonna walk in the door any minute. But I had to pull myself together really quickly. I didn't want this place to go down the tubes. It was so important to him, you know? And, of course, Al's mother was so grief-stricken that she couldn't do anything to help me. All right, I'm taking order from you guys. Excuse me. Mm. Hello?
Super young woman, isn't she?
Yes, she is.
What do you have to do to get waited on here in this joint here?
If you know you don't like it, you can go somewhere. Oh, it's you.
Uh-huh. Your doctor boyfriend's here, Andy.
He's not my boyfriend.
Could you...
He's got another babe on the other side of town.
Could you guys have a few bars of that? I think I can sing a song.
Oh, yeah. I think you know it by heart.
Okay. I surrender. And I surrendered about that babe on the other side of town, too.
Well, Debra, thank you very much for helping me unpack.
You're welcome. You took so much stuff with you. Were you thinking of not coming back?
Oh, well, I wanted to keep my options open.
Oh, well, I'm very glad you decided to come home. Gabrielle, listen, I know that everything's been really tough on you, but how could you think of leaving? All those people that love you so much.
Please, no lectures. I'm going to check on my mail. Hello, do you have some mail for me? I've been away.
I'll check, Ms. Medina.
Thank you. Well, let's see. You're in a good mood and you haven't mentioned Cord once, so what do those two things mean together?
Well, they just mean that I was waiting till we were having dinner and you were more relaxed.
Why don't you just get to the point now?
Well, it's just that I wanted to ask for your approval. I mean, you know, Cord is my first love.
Really?
Here you are.
Look, Gabrielle, I want you to stop disapproving of my relationship with Cord. It's very important to me that you approve.
Debra, I'm sorry. My opinion still stands exactly as it was. Cord is much older than you, more experienced, but mostly he is on the rebound from Tina. And as I've told you a million times, he's going to end up hurting you.
I cannot believe you have just become so bitter, just like Mummy. Instead of thinking of the joy that I have right now, all you can think of is the pain that I might have.
Well, Mummy and I must have learned the hard way.
Well, I don't want to hear it. You have become impossible, and I cannot make excuses for you any longer. From now on, Cord Roberts is off limits between us, okay?
Wait, Debra, are we going to have dinner?
I can't eat with you when you're behaving like this.
Whoa! Oh. Aren't you there, Debra? Just about knocked you in the middle of next week. How you doing? Gabrielle, hey, welcome home. You look, rested.
Oh, thank you. I've had a very restful time. And how are you?
Actually, I'm very well. See, Tina has decided she's gonna send CJ back to Landview for a little bit.
Is she going to stay?
No, thank you, ma'am. As a matter of fact, I may have to go out to San Diego myself to pick up CJ. But the big thing is, this is all gonna happen real soon, and that's what I can't wait for.
And we've got lots of things planned for CJ's visit.
Mm.
Good.
Well, I hope one of the plans is for CJ to visit with Al. I know he misses him very much.
Oh, that's definite. Are you kidding me? I know CJ is dying to get together with Al. Listen, Debra and I have been having some good times lately.
Which makes me wonder, why are you here today? Have you got a business meeting?
No, actually, I came here to see you. See, I had this incredible urge for some of Barry's famous fried clams, and I was wondering if you'd like to indulge me.
I'd love to. Isn't that what we had on our first date?
You remember. Very good.
Okay. Well, great. Let's go.
Gabrielle, would you like to come along?
No, she's got plans for this evening.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, take care, huh? We'll talk to you soon.
Bye.
Annie, what's wrong?
Look, I've got a lot of work to do around here, all right?
Annie, please, just come over here for a moment and talk to me.
So, good news? Did you convince Brenda to break off her engagement with Michael Grant?
Annie, I didn't try that. Brenda is determined to ruin her life for the security that Michael can give her instead. Now, it's taken me a long time to admit it, but I just imagined that there was something special between us.
Oh, please. You're just hurt and angry again, and now you're going to try to convince yourself again.
Annie, look, if Brenda came through that door right now and begged me to help her move out of Michael's, I would laugh.
Yeah, sure you would.
Annie, I am not messing with you. Brenda and Michael are going to be married. Now, I don't chase after married women. I only chase after young, sexy, cute, female bartenderesses.
Yeah, well, you know, hey, flattery like that might get you a free hamburger, maybe.
Or another chance, maybe.
Maybe. Come on, Dad, just open your eyes and let us know you're all right.
We love you. We've always loved you.
I can't believe how badly we treated him over the whole thing with Vicky.
It doesn't really matter. Not now, at least.
Would you step outside again for a few minutes, please?
Sure.
Megan.
Well, I think his coloring is better.
Oh, come on, sorry. He looks terrible.
Oh, hi.
Is your dad able to talk to you?
No. Not yet. What did Rafe say?
They still don't have any information. They don't know for a fact that Eddie Thomas, whether someone was hired to kill him, his cellmate.
What?
Didn't you tell Megan the truth about the hitman?
Yeah, I did. She's just a little behind on the events. Apparently, this guy appeared, Megan, and he said he saw me hit Scott Ritter. He wanted $100,000 to keep quiet.
Sarah, you've got to go to Rafe and tell him the truth. They're obviously setting you up.
Well, you see, Rafe and Beau caught this guy. He said he was working for Michael Grand.
Michael Grand?
That's what Eddie Thomas says. Then he just clammed up. Once we got him down to the police headquarters, he agreed to give an official statement.
This is the Eddie who was killed?
Yeah.
He was killed before he had a chance to confess?
Exactly. But I don't think this is a coincidence. I think Michael Grand's the one that had him killed.
Oh, my God. Well, so where does that leave you and Sarah?
Well, I mean, I have to stand trial in 2 weeks.
I don't understand. If Rafe knows that Sarah was the one that was driving the car...
No, you see, Rafe has agreed not to go to the DA with what he knows. At least for a week.
Well, what if he can't prove that Michael Grand is behind all of this?
Well, we're going to work something out because I'm not letting Sarah go to jail.
I've been so wrapped up in my own problems, I haven't known about any of this. I am so sorry.
It's okay. It's all right. We're going to work it out, right, honey?
Yeah. Hey, Sarah. Beau.
Hey,
Jake.
Hi. Glad to see you're back in one piece.
Yeah, I've got something really important I got to talk to you.
All right. Excuse me. Your father's regaining consciousness.
Oh, great. Look, we'll have to talk later, okay?
Tomorrow, the seamstress is going to come over and make any necessary alterations.
It's a beautiful dress.
Well, it better be if it's going to come anywhere near your beauty. So, do you remember everything now, Brenda?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Why don't you go upstairs and see what Mrs. Verdon and Stephen are up to? I got a phone call to make.
Oh, I remember what I wanted to tell you earlier. I was listening, and on the radio it said that Roger Gordon was hurt in a bomb blast.
Really?
Yeah.
Hurt or killed?
Well, he wasn't killed, so he was hurt.
Well, I'm glad to know he's alive, Brenda. Now, would you excuse me? Scaggs, please. Yes, sir. I understand that you're still looking for an escaped convict named Jake Harrison. I do indeed. I know exactly where he's living. Landview, Pennsylvania.
Morning.
Morning.
They're not open yet.
Yeah, I know. I'm here to see Andy.
Well, she's gone out for a while.
Is Al with her, or is he at his mother's?
Al spent the night here, and now they're over in the park.
That's a great day. I was thinking of going there myself.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, listen, do you mind if I sit around and wait for Andy?
Sure, go ahead.
Thanks.
You want coffee?
Yeah, please. So, how's business?
It's picked up a lot.
Glad to hear it.
Yeah, Andy really got herself together after Max died. Did you know Max?
Yeah, sure did. Real well.
Yeah? I don't remember you.
Yeah, well, we go back to the old days. Well, it looks like Andy did a real good job with you.
Real good. I wouldn't be surprised if she starts turning a bigger profit than Max ever did.
You kidding me?
No. That's a personal crusade of hers. Keep Max's dream alive. Poor kid. And he was the only family she had. I mean, she's a good aunt to Al and all, but...
Yeah, right.
We miss him like crazy around here. Max Holden was one of a kind.
Are you in pain, Dad?
Yeah, a little. What happened to my arm?
Didn't Larry explain to you what happened yesterday?
You suffered a very deep laceration and you burned your hand.
My head.
You're suffering from a concussion, Dad.
I don't remember what happened. Why am I here?
Well, we were hoping you could tell us, Roger.
Don't you remember me and Jake coming to the warehouse?
Jake. Warehouse.
No, you just relax, all right? It'll all come back to you very soon.
What warehouse?
At Pier 32. Dad, you opened a suitcase and a bomb exploded.
A bomb?
If Jake and I had gotten there 10 seconds earlier, we might have been able to keep you from opening that suitcase.
A bomb? You could have been killed.
Dad, we're fine. And you will be too.
Why on earth would a bomb explode in front of me?
We think you were set up, Roger. But don't worry about that now. Just concentrate on getting better, okay?
I want to remember.
Now, Dad, come on. You need some time to recover.
I'm glad you're here.
We love you, Dad. We're so sorry for the way we've been treating you.
I did a horrible thing to your mother.
Mr. Gordon? Mrs. Buchanan would like to see you.
Dad, if you're not feeling up to seeing
her... No. I'd love to see Victoria.
Good morning. Has Mr. Kirk Atherton left a message for me at all?
No.
Well, you see, we haven't met, so when he comes in, if he comes over to you, could you direct him over there?
Very well.
Thanks. Morning.
Morning. I hope you don't expect an apology.
I thought you were meant to be at the studio today. In fact, I distinctly remember you saying that you would be taping today.
Well, yes, but the actor I was working with, he had to take an emergency trip to the dentist. So we're taping my scenes tomorrow.
Oh, well, then that means you can have a workout or sunbathe or go back
anything
upstairs.
Anything but stand here and talk to you, is that right?
Oh, Debra, really.
Look, just forget it, Gabrielle. I'm on my way to meet Cord to pick up CJ, okay?
Gabriel Medina?
Oh, Kirk Atherton.
Sorry a few minutes late.
Oh, I'm very pleased you weren't on time. I'm also extremely pleased that you want to talk to me about my sister.
I'm hoping this meeting will be profitable for my ballet company.
Oh, the Scottish Ballet Theatre is world-renowned. I'm very pleased to be able to say welcome to Philadelphia. I'm planning on going to the performances tomorrow evening.
And your sister?
Yes. You see, when I read that one of your ballerinas had had an injury, I automatically thought of Debra because she's really wasting away in this small town.
Didn't I read she's acting on a soap opera?
Yes, but that's only because there hasn't been any dancing opportunities since she got back from Mendora.
I saw her command performance with the Royal Mendoran Ballet. She was magnificent.
Yes. Debra is terribly talented. It's such a shame it's going to waste.
You're telling me that she would be available and willing to step in and take over the roles Lila was scheduled to dance?
I think if you were to offer her a limited contract with a few choice roles, she'd probably jump at it.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, she's hired.
Oh, good.
But why do I get the impression we're arranging this behind her back?
Because we are. You see, my younger sister has all of a sudden become very independent, and she refuses any help from anyone, especially me. If I were to offer this to her, she'd say no. On the other hand, if you were to ask her without mentioning my involvement...
I understand. I'll just tell her that I knew she was here, which is true, and that I thought of her when Lila injured herself. What's her phone number?
Oh, yes, it's 555-2077. And tonight would be the best time to reach her.
Splendid.
What sort of role do you have in mind for her?
The one all young ballerinas dream of, Giselle.
Yes, the story of a young woman who falls in love with a prince, although he is promised to someone else.
Yes, she loses the love of her life. One of the most tragic but beautiful ballets ever created.
Yes. And my sister is perfect for this role.
Brenda, darling.
Hi. Mr. Grant, the groom's not supposed...
Oh, that's an old wife's tale, Mrs. Livingston. I'm not superstitious. Brenda, you have taken my breath away. It's going to take me 10 minutes to get it back.
I've been doing a lot of thinking, and I was just wondering... Is my dad coming to my wedding?
I've already sent him an airline ticket.
Felicia happy.
Beg your pardon?
Felicia happy being your wife.
Well, we had our problems, like any couple, Brenda, but we were committed and, yes, happy.
Well, Miss McGillis, I'm through with the hem. If you'll take the gown off, I can finish the alterations.
While she's doing that, Mrs. Livingston, why don't you go down and have Mrs. Burden give you, make you some coffee?
I will. Thank you.
Brenda? Want to change? Why were you asking about Alicia?
I don't know. I have so many questions. I just keep forgetting them low.
Well, then, probably not unnecessary questions. I have a question about Stephen.
My little love.
That's the one. You know, he's getting to be a big guy now, and he and I had a man-to-man, heart-to-heart talk. You know what he said to me? He said, Michael, you know, I really want to be your son. I want you to be my father. And I said, well, Stephen, I've got the adoption papers all ready. Just waiting for your mom to sign them.
And what'd he say?
Well, he said, well, you tell my mom that I love Michael very much, almost as much as he loves me. And I want to be his legally adopted son. You tell her I want to be his heir.
There's really something wrong with that.
Oh, no. Oh, no. There is nothing wrong with that. He and I lived together the first few months of his life, remember? Tomorrow you and I are getting married. I'm going to have full responsibility for him. Why not make it official?
I can't make a decision like that. It's a big decision,
well,
and
sure
I feel yeah. Very bizarre.
I don't know why, Brenda. Your behavior certainly isn't bizarre.
It's not?
No, no, except in the sense that you're talking as if Steve Holden might appear on the scene again.
That's not it.
Well, then, why don't you sign this and make me his father?
Victoria. Come over here where I can see you.
Did this happen because of the undercover work you were doing?
I don't know. I can't remember a thing. It's all blank. Why was it the warehouse? The suitcase? I don't even remember the bomb going off.
Well, I can't say I'm unhappy about that. I'm very, very grateful you're going to be all right.
I'll live. But unless you forgive me, I'll never be all right.
I'm sorry it took such a tragic event to put things into perspective. I adore you. I always have, and I always will. Besides, you gave me back our daughter, and that will always be important.
But forgiveness.
Well, of course I forgive you. And I forgive Clint. Of course, that's not to say I'm over this or that I will forget it. But I know you had my best interests at heart, and I think we all make terrible mistakes at some time in our lives.
Yes, I guess I made another mistake opening that suitcase.
Yeah, I'd say you did.
Damn near didn't survive either mistake. I love you, Victoria. I hope this means things are okay for us.
It means I forgive you. I don't know about the rest of it, I really don't. But you shouldn't worry about that now. You should concentrate on getting well and getting your memory back. Do you think Carlo Hesser was responsible for the bomb?
Carlo Hesser.
You and Clint had made a connection between Carlo Hesser and Michael Grand. Now, did you go out on the pier to get evidence to incriminate him? Do you remember anything?
I'm so sleepy.
No, Roger, you have to think.
Money. Evidence. There was money in that suitcase.
Why do you think there was money in the suitcase?
I don't know.
Well, go to sleep. I'm sure you'll remember everything when you wake up.
Will you stay with me and hold my hand forever?
No. I have to go win an election. I probably won't even be back for a day or two because I have an awful lot of things scheduled.
Dorian.
No, Victoria.
Yes, you're Victoria. But Dorian.
Hey, how's your dad?
He's better.
Jake. Yeah. I'd like to ask you a few questions about how you knew that Pier 32 meant trouble.
I'm sure you do, except I can't answer them right now. I'm sorry.
Well, why not? Jake, any information you have might help the police find whoever it was that did this to my father.
Look, I can't help you with that. Believe me. I get something I gotta talk to you. It's really important.
Well,
I feel like having a cup of coffee, don't you, honey?
Sure. Thank you for getting to the warehouse when you did.
You're welcome. I'm just sorry I couldn't get there sooner.
Mm-hmm. See you guys.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry that I walked out on you last night.
It's okay. I understand. You wanted to be with your father. I'm glad he's feeling better.
Yeah, well, he doesn't even remember what happened or why he went to the pier. Part of me hopes he never remembers.
Megan, he has to remember. We have to have him remember so we can nail this guy for setting him up.
Yeah, I know. You're right. I mean, he's tough. I don't think the memory will do him any harm.
I hope. So, what's this talk about?
I can't talk here. Let's go someplace where we can be private, okay?
I am beginning to feel a bit inadequate here. I'm good enough to marry you. I'm good enough to take care of you and Stephen, but I'm not good enough to be his father.
That's it.
I'm not good enough?
I think you're marrying me to get Stephen. And that's why we shouldn't get married.
Ah, Brenda.
Michael, I don't want you to be hurt. But, you know, I think you are marrying me for Stephen, and that's it. Because why else would you marry me? I'm not your type. I don't belong in your circle of friends.
Brenda, I don't have a type.
I don't
have a type. Listen to me. I love you. Why? Because you are refreshing, and you are unjaded, and you are compassionate. It would be ludicrous for me to want Stephen and not want you.
Yeah?
Brenda, I love you. You love me. We love our Stephen.
Our Stephen?
Yes.
He's mine first. But tomorrow he'll be ours.
Yes. Yes. Oh, Brenda, we don't know. We don't know what fate has in store for us. You understand? We have to seize every moment and live it to the fullest. Look what happened to Gabrielle and Max. They were going to get married. An accident. He's dead. Look what happened to you and Steve. I pray every night that nothing happens to you. I do. But if something did, I should be Stephen's legal father. Then you would know. You would know that he would be well taken care of, well provided for.
Yes, you're right.
Of course.
You're so right. Give me this. Give me this. You were always right. And now I am signing this and it.
Yes.
It's official.
Oh, yes. It's as soon as the court approves it, and there's no reason. There's no reason why they wouldn't. Would you look at this? Stephen is mine. Ours. And tomorrow, after we're married, you are mine, too.
This better be good, Jake, for dragging me away from the hospital and making me leave my dad.
It is. It's just that I couldn't talk to you at the hospital because I had a feeling what I have to say is gonna make you very mad.
Yes, I know.
Maybe even mad enough to possibly throw stuff at me.
So. Yeah, I figured that.
And it might even hurt you.
Well, I was counting on that too. So, what's up? Who are you, really, Jake? And what are you doing in Landview? And how did you know so much about my father and the danger that he was in? And are you married and do you have 5 children?
No, I can plead innocent to that one. I'm not married, and I have no children.
Of course. How could any woman marry you? You never stick around long enough.
Come on. Let's just get past that, okay? Let's just forget all about that.
Jake. Don't start hugging and kissing me here. I want some explanations.
Okay. And look, I don't know how it happened, but I'm hung up on you. It didn't mean to start out that way, but it happened, and I like you a lot. And I'm just afraid that if I tell you my confession, it might chase you away.
Well, let's hear your confession.
Well, before I came to Landview, I got in some trouble and came to town here because a rich man owed me a lot of money. And instead of paying me, he made me do things Things that I'm not very proud of. Things that I hate myself for. Things that involve you.
Oh, God, Jake, what?
Just remember, Megan. My feelings for you were a surprise. But they're honest feelings. I swear that. Can I get you anything else?
You're kidding, right? I mean, there's not much room after three cups of coffee. Listen, I guess Al and Andy are making a day of it, huh?
It could be. I mean, Andy doesn't have to be here until the evening.
Well, I guess I'll come back tonight.
Well, you want to leave a message? Say who you are, something?
No. I want to surprise her. We go back since... Forget about it. It's a long story. See ya.
Good night.
Tomorrow, Ben's got a camera and he's looking for action on Growing Pains. Then Aristotle tapes a wedding and the FBI wants it. It's America's most wanted home video on an all-new Head of the Class. And Doogie's courting an L.A. Laker cheerleader on Doogie Howser, M.D. After the school bully's sexy sister comes on to Marshall on the Marshall Chronicles. As baby Lucas lies in a coma, the shady facts of his adoption haunt a desperate Bobby. Stay tuned for General Hospital following an ABC News brief. Next.